Previously on Hard Earned.
I hate walking into the job because I know there's something going to be said. There's something going to be done.
I work for a company that's a $1 billion company. We're doing all the legwork, but we haven't seen any of the pay.
Oh, I need a new job.
Maybe I should become a nun. You think they need resumes to become a nun?
The place I worked at went down, and the only thing I can do is just sell, 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 sell. But I never thought I'd have to go back to this.
One time, I was working, and my patron asked me, what do you think about maybe manager? Me?
Working hard to feed this hunger. Whoa. Suffer through the ice cold winter to the heat of the summer. Tell me what I gotta do to earn a meal. Standing on the picket line, still waiting for a deal. Head downtown looking for a job, if that's what you call it. Down on my hands and knees in the bathroom stall, scraping out a toilet. And honest living is harder, but I know there's hope for me. For a change to come one day, saying, God, can you please give me something, something to believe
in? DJ, fight for 15.
Oh, okay, well, try your best to free up May 15th, because that's our next event that we're going to have, and we really want you to come out because we're really close to winning $15 in the union.
I've been working at Walgreens. It's been very difficult.
I was trying to put in applications every single day to get a better job. I really thought I'm going to go to the military.
And then Fight for 15 offered me a job. So I told Walgreens, I quit.
Yeah, it's gonna be what over there?
Now, I'm an organizer, and I'm trying to get more employees to understand that you deserve respect on the job.
DJ Jackson has been hired full-time by the Workers Organizing Committee of Chicago, which is leading the local campaign for $15 an hour wages.
There's a lot of potential in this. I mean, being a union organizer on your resume can get you a long way.
DJ is making $42,000 a year. Twice what he made at Walgreens. But the workload is a lot more than 40 hours a week.
Just go to the table and then you can just sign in. My role is to, I say just to relate. I understand the struggle. That's all it is. That's all this job is about. And I enjoy it. And it's fun. Tiring, but I enjoy it. I really do.
We have some international guests with us tonight. Representative of the union in Brazil.
Y por eso estamos acá. Para mostrar nuestra solidaridad como brasileños y brasileñas, para decirles que esta lucha no es solo de ustedes.
Today, the union holds a meeting to gauge support for a one-day strike of fast food workers.
The public, per se, look at McDonald's workers and Walgreens or Macy's workers just like, you guys made the choice to do that or not do something in life to have success. Wrong. There are people working at McDonald's, working fry machines, that just wasn't given an opportunity.
We're gonna have to make a decision tonight. We will vote whether or not we should go on strike.
I've been in your shoes, and I still am in your shoes right now. Financially, I'm just a little bit better, but mentally, I'm right where they are, and that gives me the greatest satisfaction, just to see a smile, and they can come out and just forget about a bill for a day.
Are you ready to strike on May 15th to join 150 cities in 30 countries?
We deserve
$15 an hour.
$15 an hour.
The right to have a union.
The right to have a union.
Can you hear us?
Can you hear us?
How about now?
How about now?
Ah,
every day I go to bed and I pray, please God, help me find something else. And it's almost like God's laughing, going, hey, you gotta go back, Amelia. Like, here's a lesson. Yeah, it's a lesson, all right. And I'm not liking it.
Aside from an 8-year stretch in the construction trades, Amelia Stancotti has worked in restaurants for most of her life.
I never thought that I would be back to waitressing. French toast?
With a side of bacon?
Mm-hmm. How would you like the eggs?
Scrambled, please.
And there I go again, you know, how would you like your eggs? Oh my God, they put cheese in there. They, you know, little Johnny wants to order. Little Johnny takes 20 minutes to order a Mickey Mouse pancake. And you want to say to the parents, you know, can you order for little Johnny? Because little Johnny can't talk. Would you like pancakes or toast?
Pancakes. Apple juice.
Yeah, she ordered the apple juice. Great, thank you.
Thanks.
Part of it, I think it's humiliating for me. Because I thought I'd be somewhere else in my life, and I'm not. But who do you blame? You know, there's nobody to blame. I made choices, and I live with the consequences every day of the choices that I made. I had opportunities to go to college and to do other things, but, you know, my drug addiction and alcoholism got in the way of that.
Amelia was 10 when her family immigrated from Italy. She traces her later substance abuse to that painful time.
This is the school. I don't recall ever playing with anybody here. There was a lot of Irish. We were dark hair, dark eyes, and didn't speak a word of English, so we stuck out really quick. The first day of school, my family was going to be waiting out here, but my sister and I, because all the doors looked the same, went out on the east side, and we just walked. Couldn't ask anybody for directions because we spoke no English. And then my family found us with the police. My parents were crying. I mean, it was just a bad situation all the way along because I think they felt bad for us, but they didn't know what to do. We were here, and now what do you do with two kids? That was a really painful time. I wonder if my life would have been different there.
About Hilton's babies. He gave me a call. And I think I just knew by the sound of his voice. You know, I asked him, I said, do you want to take a week or two off? He only wanted to be off for 3 days. He said, I need to work. I need the money.
Teníamos dos, tres citas por semana. Estaba dejando mi trabajo prácticamente toda la semana. No tenía nada de dinero.
Hilton Kennedy and his girlfriend, Diana Gonzalez, were expecting twins. After many complications, they lost both babies at 5.5 months. In anticipation of the growing family, Hilton worked two jobs, and they moved into a new place, tripling their rent.
Recuerdo algo se me viene a la mente, me pongo a llorar, me pongo triste. Pero ahora tengo que trabajar.
Hilton, did you finish the labor?
I didn't have the labor. I really don't know how to do.
So
Hilton must master the closing paperwork in order to achieve his promotion to manager.
What we do is we look for the hours. So the hours right here.
Whoa, month to date hour.
Right here. Yeah. I want you to find the month to date overtime and I'll write it for you.
This is crazy. So many numbers. How many copies? I don't remember exactly what I have to do.
All right.
Man, he's so confused.
What all the stuff he's been going through? He's what, 19, 20 years old?
there. I start 7 a.m. So it's 17 hours. Just working. Thank you, man. Have a good night. Son muchas cosas las que tengo que pensar. Solo quiero a veces olvidarme de todo.
Hilton's girlfriend, Diana, is returning to Mexico to spend a week with her mother.
Trata de en ella reflejar que esa tristeza solo se vea por dentro, que solamente ella se la vea, que no la vea la demás gente. Aún estando conmigo, trata de mostrar mi felicidad cuando yo sé que a la vez no puede estar feliz todo el tiempo. Es una persona que se tiene que admirar. De corazón fuerte.
DJ was blessed with this new job.
Caleb, why don't we take the last garbage like this?
Back to the dumpster?
And it's like, we've prayed so hard for just a little break that we could just make it. Now we're to the point where we can say we're comfortable. We actually can pay our bills, go have a dinner at night, you know, and then have money to make it to the next 2 weeks.
I want the turkey sausage,
with
the waffle.
Uh-huh.
Both? Yeah. Okay. And then can I get a side of the cheese grits?
Mari, you know he takes the cheese
grits. That girl don't look at the camera and say her life.
Ah. Lean on me, lean on me, lift you up. Lean on
you work so hard, not being able to go out to eat with the kids. Go get them a toy. Go to the movies.
Thank you. You down here?
Yes, ma'am.
When you want to do those things and more, and you just flat out can't, it breaks you down. For months and months, we said no. And that day, it was just like, yes, yes, and yes some more.
I know she ain't gonna have no success in this.
The rainbow?
No.
Of course not.
Everything all over the place. She ain't gonna have no success in this, I'm gonna be honest.
This is why I don't go to the mall with women.
See, I don't have a problem going to the mall with a woman because I probably take more time than a woman. I actually like the shoe, but.
We were in all black and silver Sunday, so I had to find a black shirt and some shoes.
Takeda needs a new outfit for the 25th anniversary of her church choir.
I found the shirt and accessories. All I have to do is find some shoes, and I'll be done. It's like this every year for the concert.
It's not about my opinion, it's about how comfortable you are.
But how they look.
It's an okay shoe, it's not a bad shoe.
All that I'm saying is the fact that there's no difference between that shoe and the one that you have at the house. As far as
clothes, I don't want no silver shoe. I'm not getting a silver shoe.
You can't just keep wearing black shoes.
Well, silver not gonna be that color, because I'm not gonna wear silver like that.
honestly, I don't think I should get this shit.
This looks bigger than what it looks like in the computer. We can put our pictures from our wedding up here.
Jose and Elizabeth Marino take the afternoon off from work to look at two houses for sale.
Right now, the living situation is crazy.
The recently married couple live with their parents. They're in desperate need of more space.
This is where we all three sleep.
Yes, when we sleep over here. Definitely not big enough for three people.
When I saw Aiden one day that he was angry, he went under the bed and he was crying and he said that that's his safe spot. He has nowhere to go in this house because he doesn't have his own room.
All right, so we're ready to head off to the next one?
Yeah.
Yep.
They want to stay in Montgomery County, where their families have lived for three decades. But housing costs here are now among the highest in the U.S.
So what do you think?
Minus the cons that I told you
water
about.
In the backyard, layout the kitchen, the vent in Aiden's room, the old heat pump, the washer and dryer layout. Can you please tell me something positive about the house? Give me something that you like about the house.
Other than the stuff that I told you?
You only wrote driveway, and I wrote driveway. I wrote granite countertops. I wrote the layout of the house. I wrote the extra space in the basement.
Right. I'm not thinking about all that stuff.
What are you thinking
besides
about?
Besides the stuff that's a con, I like the house.
You
it's
have a,
pro. A
big list. My gosh.
She calls me negative. But there's a battle between the cup being half full or half empty, and I look at it as just liquid in the cup. It's neither or. There's something in the cup. That's the fact.
I already don't like it.
Here, I think we made a decision.
What's the decision?
We're going to go with the other one. We're going to ask for full closing. How long do you guys see yourself living there?
Forever. I see me raising my kids there. I see them coming back from college. I see them there.
Are we excited about it?
I am.
I know you are.
I like the property.
Are we saying yes to the house?
I like it.
Okay.
Let's put it off on it.
So now I'll work my magic for you guys.
I cannot. This is the one. This is the one. This is the one.
Let's make it happen.
We haven't got it yet.
Let me get to work on it right now.
I don't like that. That froze.
If I know then what I know now, I don't think I'll buy a house.
If I get on the latch and latch freeze, then I'm in trouble.
You know, the upkeep seemed like you'd never get through paying for something. Where was that? The city came and tore sidewalks up, and we had to pay that.
It's just been just one big headache, actually.
Percy and Beverly Evans bought their house 13 years ago for $79,000 when they had better paying jobs.
We were only in the house like 2 months.
2 months, right.
And the loan was sold to another company. And in the meantime, I had sent the payment to the company that we were with. And then they were suing us because we hadn't sent the payment. You know, because the old company had the payment and they should have passed it on to the new company and they didn't. So that was a problem. We did a modification a few years ago and the payment came down, but then it went back up again.
We're paying over 9% interest, our mortgage.
It is 9% interest. And the payments are $1,190 per month.
So how much of the principal do you still owe on there?
Well, let me see. What does it have? 79.
That means nothing's gone towards the principal in all this time.
How many years has it been?
Right now, it's 13.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Percy and Bev have missed a number of mortgage payments. They have filed for bankruptcy to ward off foreclosure.
Right now, we're about chapter 13.
That's what we mean by being house poor, you know. I think you need to be able to do something other than pay for a house and sit up in it and can't go anywhere, can't do anything, you know, can't have anything, you know.
I keep on shaking this. I don't know why.
I don't know.
I guess when I worked at the restaurant,
well, you don't have to shake it.
Okay, I won't. I'm going back in here and watch TV.
You don't have to go back in there. Just don't shake the skillet.
Come on now. Down here in the basement, this would be my man cave, you know. I just ramble through things I have stored away. Look at my old bowling trophies. I can sit back and listen to music. I won't have to worry about anything coming down here. When I play music, I like for it to rock. I like to move. I like to just move around. I don't just like to sit down and have the blues.
This house, it's been a problem. But then you find it's nothing like having a house where you can do what you want to do. You know, you can be loud, you can have parties. I mean, not that we did, but I mean, you can. Our children could come, our grandchildren could come over.
The house, that's something that you work your whole life for. And it can just be taken away just like that, you know. My parents' door is never closed. Their grandkid lost her job, and she needed a place to live. Oh, I went back. We all been back at one point or another. We need that house.
If Percy and Bev fail to stay current on their mortgage payments, they will lose the bankruptcy protection, and the home will go immediately into foreclosure. Jose and Elizabeth's offer on the house was accepted. They do a final walkthrough with their parents.
Ellie?
You like it?
Love it.
Oh, gosh. You're so tiny.
It's all right, Mom.
It's okay. You got it. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations.
We got the house for 303. That's how I'm looking at it. Minus the 10 that we put on for closing.
Well, where were we? 313.
Right? Yeah, but that was with the 10 extra for closing.
Yeah, but that goes towards closing, not towards the loan of the house. That's what I was trying to tell you. Mm-hmm. So it's the 313 plus the closing costs. Do you see what I'm saying?
No.
The house is appraised at 322, but our selling price is 313, is what he's trying to tell
you. Right. So you did get the 10. For
exactly.
The
so
closing.
If you take away the 10.
But if you take away the 10, you would still have to pay the 10. That's the thing. So they're just paying it for
what
you.
What I'm saying is, we got the house for 303.
303, if you look at it that way.
Yes, that's how I'm looking at it.
Okay. But technically, we have for 313. At the end of the day, you're happy?
Yes.
You're happy?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
Okay, that's all that matters. You won't remember the price 10 years down the road from now.
Monthly payment?
It should be rounding up to $1,799. It is a 30-year fixed rate.
Jose's veteran benefits qualify the couple for a VA loan with a low interest rate and no down payment.
When I look at it, and in 30 years, I'll be 62,
That sucks. To be slaving, you know, 30 years to paying this, but...
I'll be 57. At 57, to be done paying a house, that's a great age. I mean, 50s are the new 30s, I've heard. So, I mean, like, at least that's what I heard. No. I look at my parents. My parents came here looking for a better life. Jose's mom came here looking for a better life. We're now the second generation to do this. I just want to live what everybody else lives.
One, two, three.
The typical American dream.
Vine aquí a Estados Unidos a tratar de hacer algo más y tener lo mejor posible para mi familia. Y me promete esto, me promete más dinero, güey. Le dio pinche aumento de 22 centavos el vato. Un año, güey.
¡Ábrela! ¡Ábrela! ¡Rebótala!
Me di cuenta que en Estados Unidos trabaja uno duro y no puede uno progresar. Pienso ahorrar, pero ahora sube mi renta. Entonces va a salir el carro. Entonces, gasolina, placas, aseguranza.
¡Atrás, atrás!
En Estados Unidos siempre estamos buscando algo mejor. Ese es el problema.
How you doing? Pay my light bill, ma'am. I just need to.
DJ and Takeda have neither bank accounts nor credit cards. They pay bills and cash checks at a currency exchange.
That's 65 right there.
Establishing a credit history, I just don't think about it too much. To be honest, just a lot on the table. I just don't go that far into it. But I know that I need to. I do understand that credit pretty much makes the world go round.
Damn, man. Thank you, ma'am. All right, same to you. All right. One down, seven more things to do.
We have so many issues that we go through on a daily basis. If it's parenting, it's everything is just life.
Stand right there, don't move.
I'm a little stressed out right now. The reason I love basketball so much is because basketball is my place of peace. If I can get that little ball in my hand and go to a court and find me a rim, I'm the sweetest guy. But I played terrible today. I mean, I played terrible. And when I'm not playing well, I have anger issues.
No, we okay with the loss, man. But don't say it. You don't talk. You a sh- talking all the time.
That's one thing I pray about all the time. God, please just step in. Hold my tongue. I need that because what can stop me from being that man I really want to be is my anger. And that comes from situations with my dad. My father is the core of my anger. My father was so distant, like he fathered through money.
And he didn't know how to give time. And it's always been his way or no way. I think about reconciling my father all the time. Just to sit down and say, Pops, I love you like, man, you don't even know. But he said something to me that tore me down. My pops told me, you have been a f-. Those were his exact words. For the last past 5 years, you have been a f-. That's why I don't call him. That's why I don't ask to see how he's doing, because I want to make it, then call. That's how serious, I want to make it on my own, then call him. So you don't have any room to say you helped out because you wasn't around and I made it by myself. Now that I made it by myself, let's fix this situation. That's how long I'm willing to let it crack.
So let me give you a background on what we're doing.
Sure.
And what we go from there. So we're kind of giving them tools in their toolbox of life. We're teaching them about all kinds of different things. And drugs and alcohol prevention is at the basis of this. So out of the middle of nowhere.
Amelia is contacted unexpectedly by a youth organization that heard about her recovery from substance abuse.
We were interested in your story and just wanted to see if you were interested.
I am. I just, you know, I'm not formally, I don't speak formal, you know, like I haven't gone to school to speak publicly.
I think that's what makes it so genuine.
You think so?
The people who get the best response are people who speak about your experience.
I would certainly do my best. I mean, what I do, you know, I'm in recovery, and I've been in recovery for 23 years, and,
right.
You know, it's really important to teach kids.
What I'm looking for is a 45-minute talk. I have 180 kids there. So for payment, I don't know if we told you how much I can pay you.
No.
$500?
Get out of here.
That's the going rate. So
you're kidding me.
I have it in my budget. I'll write you a check. I'll have it that day. No,
Jesus
Christ. There was a guy in New York who wanted to come in and charge. He wanted me to, for an hour of work, $4,000 plus pay for all of his travel expenses. So.
Wow.
My point is, it's a big business. And then once, you know, you do well with us, we'll go and tell other people what a great job you did. Because we're always looking for new stuff. Everybody is.
Wow. It's an honor. I would love to talk to kids because I think they need it.
They do. Thanks again. I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Take care.
Bye-bye. Are you kidding me? They pay $500. I do this for free. Oh, my God. Wow.
How you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Good?
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Same, yeah.
Percy used to make $45,000 a year until the place where he worked shut down. Now he cleans a shopping mall for $8 an hour, working through a temp agency. He hopes to find something better.
We're stealing from Peter to pay Paul. I'm not looking for charity or nothing like that. I'll go out and sell cans before I go ask somebody else here to give me something.
All right, it's all set for you.
Oh yeah, right. We got it. I start coming down. I'm just hanging around the house after a while, you know, and looking at the walls, and it start creeping in on me. And then next thing you know, I'm watching TV and then soap operas. I'm not in a soap opera. It's time for me to move out.
Oh, man.
Domino, man. 15 and Domino.
Percy's janitorial job is at night, leaving his days free.
A lot of people here live alone. And this is their life, coming here 5 days a week. They come down here, be amongst friends, get their meals and everything. And
Percy's friends have retired from manufacturing jobs with pensions. When the social service agency where Percy worked for 18 years closed, he was left with almost nothing.
Yeah, we retired, man. I retired in August of 05. They closed in March of 06. Welder.
I was a crane operator. 32 years.
We worked all this time, and we hope to retire with some kind of benefits or some kind of respect.
Yes,
we don't get any respect. We swept under the carpet. You know, like I said, we're losing our homes and things.
Well, this is what's happening, man. This country turned its back on the people that built it.
Yeah, I was in that war. Yeah.
Well, World War One.
None of your business.
1812.
Oh, shut up and play.
When you retire in Canada, you don't have to worry about health care.
That's right.
You tend to have. You know, they take care of you.
That's right.
And I don't understand why we can't get.
Because they don't want you, brother, to make it. You've worked all your life. Not a system ought to want to work for you. But that's not capitalism, bro. Capitalism, bro. Capitalism ain't for you.
Percy's temp agency has moved him to a janitorial position at a family-owned machine shop. He now makes $10.50 an hour.
My parents didn't give me anything. Everything I got, I had to work for. That was instilled in me to work. My mother and father, how they had to work, how my father had to go out into the cotton fields and pick cotton or haul pulpwood and things like that. I feel blessed because I know a lot of people my age can't do as much as I do. I got a little arthritis on my wrist. But we still trying to keep a house. So I'm gonna keep on working.
I do like to start out with just going over the deed.
Okay.
They're the documents that lets the world know. You bought this house and this is how much you paid for it.
Okay. Well, I don't understand why it's 328.
So our total price at the end of the day of purchasing the house, that's what I guess Jose and I also have a question, is 328?
328. No. Okay, so 313
mm-hmm.
plus your five
mm-hmm.
plus that.
Okay.
That equals this.
Right.
Are you with me? Your total price is $323,088.47.
Yeah, I mean, now I'm like, oh man, because we were fixated on the $313,700, but I guess we, you know, because of the closing costs.
Well, you have to add in closing costs.
So your loan amount is still $317,000. Is that your concern? $313,700. That's still your loan amount.
Okay.
Okay, that's what I'm reading between the lines.
You're reading me, right? Jose is starting to get a little hot.
Having a VA loan, you do not pay a settlement fee. So it's sort of a nice...
You should be happy about that, Vim.
He's not... He's just glazed over.
He's taking it all in a day at a time.
That's right.
So everybody's like cracking jokes and just like, you know, signing the paper. I wasn't angry, I was serious. Like, that was a serious moment.
Okay.
I'm trying to scan through all the stuff to figure out what I'm signing. She's like, oh, this is just this, this is this, it's okay. So many freaking paperwork in there. You don't know what you're reading, you don't know what you're signing. I remember my mom went into, when she bought her house, she had a lawyer with her.
This document here is called the Truth in Lending. This document is the scary one. This tells you over the life of the loan how much you're gonna pay for the loan. So.
Look at that big figure.
See that,
I know.
See that big number?
I know. Jose's
shell shock.
Take it in, babe.
I know, he seems so like.
It's my husband.
What do I sign?
All right.
Oh, hey, hey, hey. You heard that, Rob. Get that on recording.
So, let me be the first to congratulate you as new homeowners.
Thank you so much.
Elizabeth.
Thank you.
It's very emotional.
I know. We will, thank you.
Yeah, your little house. Are you crying? Oh, honey, don't cry.
Y hace tres semanas les pregunté por ese día. Claro, porque tengo un examen sin temeros. ¿Cuál es mi trabajo más importante? Que estoy progresando ahora, entonces. Mi jefe en Google me dijo que no. Me dijo, prácticamente tienes que decidir entre Soy Tomeros y nosotros, si es eso lo.
Hilton gave his 2 weeks notice to the food service contractor at Google. Today, he's traveling across town to pick up his final paycheck.
Supuestamente hoy era mi último día trabajando en Google. Pero el jueves pasado me habló el chef a la oficina. Me dice, sabes, Hilton, no tienes que preocupar por venir el lunes, solamente ve por tu cheque a recursos humanos el lunes.
Goodbye,
mijo. Bueno, ahora sí.
Cuídate, mucho. Te amo. Tú eres chingón.
Cada vez es más trabajo, más presión. Por alguna razón, los dishwashers son las últimas personas a las que nombran o las últimas personas que toman en cuenta. Todos hacen un buen trabajo en la cocina, pero si el dishroom está bien y todo, nadie los toma en cuenta.
No llegó mi cheque, no está mi cheque aquí, entonces supuestamente tienen que reenviarlo.
Más que nada es el respeto.
Now that he only has one job, Hilton is counting on a promotion to junior manager at Sweet Tomatoes. First, he must pass a food safety exam, which he has already failed once. He's on his way to take it again.
¿Cuáles son los dos virus?
I told him, I said, you just need to pass the test, whatever it takes. It's not easy whatsoever. Hello, may I speak to Benson? Benson?
This job is a little stressful sometimes.
What would be stopping you? I mean, $15 can change a lot, you know? Paying bills, getting treated a little bit better. You said $15 wouldn't change your life? $15 an hour? Exactly, yes.
I love DJ's new job, but the stressful part about it is, you know, he works late, sometimes the kids doesn't see him, and it's like kind of replaying sometimes what used to go on at Walgreens.
The big day has arrived for Takeda's church choir and her new outfit.
Yeah.
when we were living paycheck to paycheck, no one knew we were struggling. No one knew what was going on because we've always paid our bills. We've always had our kids dressed right.
We still live check to check. Regardless of me getting better money, there's just so many bills to pay.
Everything is not always gonna go as sweet as you want it to go. It's always gonna be bumps in the road. We're just a family that's trying to make it every day off no perks. We're young. We're just trying to make it as a family.
Next time on Hard Earned.
Nunca había trabajado. Ahorita ya me va a dar 5 días.
We just gained more responsibilities. I'm anxious.
Okay, Dad, we have our issues, but we have to at least speak.
You want to introduce Amelia, who has never done this in her life, ever.
I am really, really nervous.
I let me have to beg them to call the ambulance on Monday.